So here we have Devastator fully combined, and yeah, he looks really good in my opinion by the anatomy of two legs that they chose to went with. And because what I'm gonna say is went with an odd decision of having this figure standing in two legs, while in the movie he was standing in four-legged, and that is pretty odd. But then again, I'm gonna say there was a concept art of Devastator that they went with the four leg, and I'm gonna put that picture in right now for comparison. So I'm gonna say this, they went with another option from the movie and it doesn't work, because clearly if you look at the concept art that he's standing really tall and really bulky and has a humanoid more like configuration. But here we have, it's really odd, because to me the different length of the arms are really disturbing. Why is that happening? I don't really know, but then that is really disturbing in my opinion. I know that you need to do two deluxe figure to fully complete the movie, but then you could just make Scavenger a leader class or giving him some extend features so the arms are more balanced. But instead you just went with this art, and then as a result you have two different length arms. The head sculpt is beautiful, just like I mentioned with my MIG Master video. Check out that video down in the description. Everything looked nice, but then again, all that nice thing combining together gave me a really odd feeling about the figures. It's like they don't even try to be movie accurate. So like, they try to be movie accurate throughout the whole set, but then with this one, they just don't. I really don't understand that. And the details are nice, especially look at MIG Master. The Vortex Grinder and the face sculpt are really beautiful and highlight the beauty of him. And again, if I'm gonna turn him around, so just so you can see the back is really nice. And especially I love the way they cooperate Rampage base onto his ass, because that is just nice storage. I really enjoy that. Then again, the leg are just as usual, just plug them in, nothing too spectacular here. But then again, you can see upon, if you turn into back, you can see Longhaul's head and then Scavenger's head showing out. That is really disturbing. And one more thing I gotta say about, I'm really surprised that with this figure, with such a massive weight, it can hold itself on two legs pretty well. That is due to the supportive of the two legs. They are really nice, so that you have two really big feet and then it's pretty kind of solid, and I really love that. And again, it is a nice figure. Then I'm gonna talk about the arms right now. So if you look at the arms, as you can see, he has some range of articulation. You all know that that joint of Hightower and Scrapper, he can have a knee bend, yeah, like that. Like the knee bends here, he doesn't have that much or at all, but then the arms are really articulated due to the connecting parts of the figures. And then if you look at the claws of Scrapper are better looking than the claw of Scrap Metal. It is because the claw of Scrapper is more balanced and they have that rule of two up and one down, like that. But then with Scrap Metal, there are three downs. So it looks really odd. I mean, it looks more like a human or a beast claw, but then again, it looks odd because it cannot show that at all. It looks like an angry cat or something. Speaking of animals, do you know what kind of animals is this? I don't really know. Then again, if you turn him into the shoulder joint, you can see that the whole section are empty. They're hollow inside, and I don't really enjoy that, to be honest with you. And then again, if you notice that this is way too heavy for a leader class, because the joint are wobbly wobbly, because that they're too heavy, and simply the Scavenger arms cannot hold them all together. That's why there's a peg in the back that allows you to lock the whole thing together. Yeah, that is really nice. That is okay and kind of fun. And now to the worst part, I'm gonna say the negative things I feel about this figure. I mean, what the did you produce, Takara and Hasbro? You have us waiting for 2 years. This figure on up to until your price is $300, and it costs more than that for different people in different parts of the world. And you give them a big pass pie of plastic without any articulation at all. Don't lie to me. Don't you ever lie to me. All of you in the comment section below, don't you ever discuss to me that I should be grateful for this figure. I'm not. I'm paying for it. And to be honest with you, all the joints here are scrap, because I'm gonna say this, they get you the elbow joint, but then it's too weak and too wobbly to hold the post. And what kind of post do I want with this when he cannot bend his knee? You cannot bend the knee, or you cannot move the fucking head. The head stay in one place. So like, what is the point of an elbow bend? I mean, to be honest, I'm sorry for that. And that is because this figure is designed to stay in one place, but then I got a better idea. But first, size comparison. Size comparison time. Here he is with Deluxe Class Soundwave. Here is with Voyager Optimus. Optimus can suck his dick right now. Here is with Leader Class Shockwave. As you can see that he looks really big in this mode. Looks really strong and should be the Autobot's greatest nightmare, just as in the G1. And that will be it for my review of Devastator today. And to be honest with you, I'm never gonna post him like this because he looks like shit. But then again, thanks to my intelligentness, I'm gonna combine him into the alternate mode and I'm gonna show it in the next video, so stay tuned for that. And anyway, I'm challenging you, Prime vs Prime, since you obviously asked my thoughts about Devastator. Let's have a vote to see which of one of our alternate mode looks better. I'll see you later. Turn it out, guys. Subscribe to my YouTube and follow my Instagram. See ya!